Good morning, sunshine. Ready to get this done?
Ready.
We got spindles left and rear blocks and traction bars, and we should be pretty much complete. So far, the sucky part about having a different lift kit previously is we had to remove the brackets off the sway bar, and we weren't really sure if that was factory or not. So there's a lot of stuff like that with the rough country kit that we weren't sure if it was factory or if it was part of the lift kit. So keep in mind, if you're going from one lift kit to another, you might be spending a little extra time removing some of the other components. Status update, we got the torsion drop bracket, and then now we're about to put the leveling keys, and we're one step closer to being done. Sheesh, look at that. Sick. Mondo's about to mount the tires onto the hostel wheels. And here we have the reservoir mounts. Oh, look who showed up after 3 days of sleeping. Sleeping duty over here. This man doesn't usually sleep. He sleeps like 2 hours a day maybe. And then sometimes he'll go like 3 days without sleeping. So I think his body was finally like sick of it. So it made him sleep for 3 days. Finally showed up.
But he's back in business.
Back in business. We got the A team here. Got this sucker mounted on there. Time to balance them. But real quick, we gotta go take a lunch break and go get some hardware because some of the components did not fit. I'm gonna get the large Caillou.
What do you want?
Ice coffee. How bad is it?
Oh.
Oh, is it bad?
Oh.
Is it bad? Oh no.
It's touch upable.
Okay, good.
But it's gonna be sanded a little bit.
Oh dang, I heard it too. I felt it. We're gonna get a lot of practice. We're gonna practice touch ups. We gotta do mine too.
It's like not on the face of the lip, it's like on the corner where the tire beats.
Oh, so that's not bad.
It's still bad.
We gotta check out the damage. Oh, that's it?
That's it.
Oh, dang.
But it's still damaged.
That does suck though.
Yes.
That's gonna be fun. Sand it down.
This is gonna bug me forever.
He's probably gonna go out and buy a new wheel. Did you buy that insurance from Archon?
No.
Oh.
It was $250.
Did it cover curb?
Yeah. Everything. Anything. Any damage.
Like if you curbed it?
Yeah.
Wow.
Damn, I should have.
See if it's too late.
Archon.
Archon, I think you should just send him a new wheel for free. Sponsor him.
Yes, Archon. At least one. No, I need two.
Two? Why?
I can use that one to build a table out of.
Heck yeah, again. How are these balancing? Pretty good?
A little high.
A little high?
Cool. About
4 hours. We'll see how these ride, because I have a feeling they're going to be kind of rough, but we'll see. But one thing I do want to show you guys, this is pretty new with Mcgaughy's. These traction bars with the 2020 Duramax, when you order the traction bars, it comes with obviously the traction bars that it comes in raw, so you have to go get it powder coated or painted, which I prefer powder coat over painting. Dang. Anyway, I prefer powder coating over painting just because it's more durable So once you get the traction bar, it comes with these little inserts. You can powder coat them, but it actually comes in polished. So what you do is, if you flip the traction bar, there's a little door right here, and this is the cover for the door, like this. And then all you have to do is slide the insert in here, and then it will look like this. So this is really cool. They didn't offer this on the older kits. Like my LML didn't have this option with a traction bar. It was just one solid traction bar, didn't have any kind of inserts. This is a really nice touch on Mcgaughy's part. It matches the front ladder bar that's right there. But I'm so glad I powder coated all the inserts, because they all match. So I think it was a good choice. So we got it down on the ground. Wow, look how good it looks. Look at that. I'm so glad I powder coated the spindles, because you can see it. I think it's the little things that counts. And I just love how the wheels are just completely all blacked out, going for that murdered out look with a little bit of lime green or lime yellow accent. Gosh, that's killer. So we measured, if we look, front is 14 1/8, and then the back is just rough country 5-inch lift. So yeah, it's about 2 inches shorter, lower in the back. So I am squatting right now, but honestly, it really doesn't even look like it's squatting. It looks pretty level. But we're gonna put the rear blocks and the shims to set this at probably like 8, 8.5 in the back. And then the front is gonna be all the way at 9 inches. A little sneak peek of behind the scenes of JW Motorsports Co. Wheel lights. Gotta solder up all the connections. And a little behind the scenes of powder coat action. We are powder coating a few more stuff. That's still pretty hot. So the dust shield and a few other components that I wasn't planning on powder coating, that now we are. So it's gonna be pretty cool. So we got pretty much everything finished up on the truck. Only issue we ran into is we found out the hard way that those U-bolts are too short to work with the shims and for the traction bar, for it to work with the traction bar bracket.
And we dropped it.
And we dropped it, which we didn't have to say anything, but Cam brought it up, so we dropped it. Luckily, Mark has an extra U-bolt, so we might have to drive up about an hour to Columbia and then pick up those U-bolts and then finish up the traction bars later this week, because I got plenty of stuff that I need to do before the Atlanta truck invasion. One of them being getting my mirrors put on, gotta get an alignment done, and I do have a rock chip here that I'm gonna attempt to at least fix up, just because I'm getting this whole side PPF'd and I don't want to PPF over that. We have this beautiful LML Duramax that belongs to StarFits_LML.
Got walking.
We have this beautiful Duramax with candy blue Mcgaughy's lift kit.
All right, in place of JW, I'm doing a little bit of filming for him. So we've got everything dropped from the truck, upper arms, lower arms, knuckle, diffs out, cross member mount has been cut. We got the torsion bars out and the Mcgaughy's torsion drop slightly installed for now. That's where we are until JW gets here to film the rest of this shit. Diffs back up. We got the diff drop brackets down on it. Got one for the passenger side and one for the driver's side. Diff's wired back up, plugged back in, everything's secured. So next is gonna be the lower cross members. So the front and rear cross members will go up next. And then I guess the lower arms with the torsion bars will run to the front. JW still ain't here recording this shit like he's supposed to. So
always I'm
doing
late.
Doing it for now. No, Cam's always late.
Cam
always making us late. All right, JW still ain't here. We got the Mcgaughy's front cross member on, rear cross member, bump stop extensions, and I think I already said the diff was back up in the truck. Next is gonna be put the lower arms back on and then the kicker braces, and hopefully he will be here by then. Till then, you're gonna hear me being the man behind the camera.
Mondo's about to put kryptonite upper control arms and the leveling keys to set this truck at 9 inches. He got his upper control arms powder coated to match the whole suspension components. So let's go ahead and install the upper control arm. Just like that, the stock one is out. Time for the kryptonite one. So here we have it pretty much 90% finished. All we have to do is I gotta pick it up tomorrow and take it for an alignment, and then after the alignment I gotta go get my side panels PPF'd. And for those of you guys that don't know what PPF is, it's paint protection film. So it's like basically like a screen protector that goes along the side of the truck, because well, with these 14 wides I'm already expecting a lot of rock chips. So to prevent that from getting more rock chips, because I already have a couple that I touched up and I actually accumulated a couple more on the other side, so we're going to PPF it, picking up the mirrors tomorrow, and then we should be good to go. And then later in the week I have to go get some U-bolts, either from Mark or Mcgaughy's actually might send me the actual U-bolts that I need, and we may be able to install the traction bars before the Atlanta truck show. But there's a slight chance that I may not be able to. It is what it is. I am gonna be for sure putting on the traction bars for Daytona. So stay tuned for that. I know this isn't the most exciting reveal video. Check out that lineup though. We have Mondo's 2021 Ram 2500 Cummins. And then we have J-Star's LML. Mcgaughy's lift. We turned the keys up a little bit today and put the kryptonite upper control arms right here. So this truck is indeed sitting at 9 inches, and this truck, it's crazy what going from 7 to 9 inch will do, because this truck just seems way bigger than it was before. He is running 24x14 Archon chrome wheels. I forget what these are. I think these are the, whatever these are, I forget. But he's also running 1.5 inch spacer in the front and then 2 inch in the back. So this is a pretty wide setup, but not as wide as this setup, because this is 16 wides with 2 inch wheel spacers all the way around. And we are headed to Daytona in 2 weeks. Mondo is gonna be at the Boost Auto Parts booth, park next to Truckmaster. That's gonna be pretty sweet. And I will be at the hostel booth, park next to Mcgaughy's. So yeah, it's gonna be pretty exciting. Crunch time is real. He's got a couple of pieces that he's getting paint matched before Daytona. And obviously I got a list of things to do before Daytona as well. But also J-Star is gonna be cruising down to Daytona with us. There's gonna be a group of us all cruising down to Daytona on Thursday morning. And along with paint matched parts, we actually have to put Mcgaughy's steering stabilizer and the brackets on there, which is gonna really change the front end of that truck, just because it's gonna have really cool dual stabilizer bars right there. and then we might put some custom decals on it to give it a little bit of a custom look to it. Then for J-Star, he may have some custom headlights that he may be putting on before Daytona. It'll either be color match to match the front end of the truck, or that grill is actually Plasti-Dip, so he said he may just peel the Plasti-Dip off and go for that chrome front end look since he's got chrome wheels. And before we head out, let's see how this truck looks with the rock lights activated. It's not dark enough, but whoa, look at that. Dang.
Look at the front McGaughy's.
The front McGaughy's? Dang. Wow. So I may adjust it because that's pretty. There we go. Maybe that's better. I might put two more, like one here, one there, to really shine that McGaughy's.
That McGaughy's looks so good.
Dang, yeah, I might put two more to really light it up.
It almost looks like it's lit up from behind.
Right? You can get those rock lights at jwmotorsportsco.com. Those are the premium ones I have. But dang! Look at this side piece. It lights it up perfectly too. It almost looks like it glows. I can't wait to see this at night. All right, so we are going to be leaving the truck over here at Elite Innovations overnight. We gotta pick it up first thing in the morning tomorrow and then take it for an alignment. And then after the alignment, like I said, we gotta PPF it, pick up the door, pick up the mirrors, and then after mirrors, traction bars. So keep on the lookout. Just make sure to hit that subscribe button.
Like, comment, and subscribe.
If you guys wanna continue following the build, gosh, I am super excited. And by the way, I actually forgot to tell you guys, it was kind of a secret. I have Go Recon taillights and third brake light that are smoked out. So that is going to look super, super good with the overall theme of this truck. Cause I want like the top half or the top of the truck would to be like murdered out. And then everything below has like green, the neon yellow accent pieces. And so far, I'm loving it. I think that's the perfect amount of neon yellow. I know a lot of people want me to start powder coating more neon yellow underneath, but I think this is a good stopping point because once I start powder coating more, it's like, where do I stop? You know, that puts me in the category of having to try to be matchy-matchy and having to powder coat like literally every piece, and that's really not what I want to do go for. Like, I want this to be a badass daily drivable vehicle that looks like a show truck, but at the same time, like, literally only thing that's powder coated is like very small accent pieces that really anybody can do. So that is kind of the goal I have for this truck. You know, I could go full blown out like Mark and have every little accent piece powder coated, and I think it looks great on Mark, but that's just not really what I want to go for with this truck, because I probably drive this truck a lot, and for Mark, I know he doesn't drive it very much, so it's it makes sense for him to do all that more detailed in this build. I do have like this service def light that's on, so I may need to retune the truck. I'm not really sure why that's doing it. I know the battery was dead for 2 days. I don't know what drained the battery, but it was dead. We had it jump started today, and after we did that, the service light came on, or the service def light came on. So I need to talk to Same Day Tuning and get that figured out. But that is it for this video, you guys. Make sure to hit that subscribe button. Keep on the lookout. Follow the journey of this truck. We got some pretty cool content coming up. This weekend, in like in a couple of days, we're going to Atlanta for the Atlanta Truck Show. Brunch time is real for that show. And then after that, relax for a couple days, and then we are headed over to Daytona. It's gonna be fun couple of weeks, so stay tuned. Let me know in the comments below if you're coming to any of the shows, and if you are, please let me know. I would like to meet up with you guys. I want to check out some of your builds. But thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up. Let's get it to about 500 likes, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.